Gucci and I crack them to my song. Bitches tryna hide they ratchet. Why you on beat a little bit? Hey there, it's Scotty, and welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, we're all new to this a little bit. InZoi just released its character creation. InZoi is a new life simulation game akin to The Sims. This is basically a Sims channel. I ain't posted in a little bit, but that's okay. We're coming back. this is related in a way. Anyway, but I've just been excited for the game, and so I saw all the InZoi content creators, I guess, out here. They got, like, you know, a version of the game, and then InZoi, in a lovely marketing scheme, it's been happening with games, they released their character creator, and it goes off. Like, I had a good time in character creation. So you probably just saw me flash my starting scene screen, because I had put it was a sim that I had made in InZoi, and, you know, I had taken pictures of her and everything. So that was Jean Michli, Vauclain Schwab, from my Twitch LP New Royals. Adore her, love her. You've seen her in Ziomara and stuff, because I am incapable of playing with Sims who are not related to each other. And so on Twitch, Jean-Marie met a man named Etienne Babineau, and he's an actor. He lives in Delso Valley. She lives in Windenburg. And so they're, like, kind of long distance. Like, when they're in town, they're, like, in a relationship. So I was like, if I made Jean-Marie, let me make him. You can, in the character creator, only really put one Zoi in a family at this point. So I wasn't really able to put them together or get pictures of them together as Zois. But I was at least able to create this Zoi, and then have them saved to my canvas, so I can at least have them in the future. So I've really enjoyed the process. We're really just kind of, like, looking at it and learning. This is the first guy I had made, and yeah, so those are pictures of who we're making. Basically, we're making that man, and because we already made that woman. And we'll see it in the end here. I did, you know, we were just fooling around in the studio, listening to music, so you'll see me jiggle and move around. You have been forewarned, your boy is a wiggler, okay? That means when music is coming on, music is being played, if it bops, if it hits, I will wiggle, okay? It's not full dancing. We're sitting in a chair. So, you see, the boy wiggles, all right? He just does. And you're just gonna have watching this back, I was like, you just really be dancing on stream. But anyways, yeah, so that's me over there in the corner, in the spotlight, absolutely losing my religion, because, yeah, this was fun, and we were just listening to music, having a good time. So we're kind of getting into the face, and I was just, like, kind of switching back and forth between looking at, like, the picture of, like, the Zoi I'm creating. The skin tones can get quite rich. They can get quite in there, Miss Girly Poppington. They really do, because there's a color wheel, basically, or like a color picker, whatever. And all the shading and blending and all the, and then just the plethora of skin tones that they have. You know, you can definitely go in and make a nice little lovely blended skin tone. And then with the makeup options, which you'll see, you can add, like, what kind of feels like an undertone, which are important in creating, like, skin tones. Like, people have undertones. So it really did work out. I had a good time, like, just even in character creation. So I've been, since then, been very, like, thirsty for gameplay videos, so I've run across a nice little plethora of new InZoi creators, and you know, shout out to them and all the things that they do. Yeah, but so there are a lot of options, and you just have to like sit there and get used to it. It's kind of like The Sims. Like, you can get I don't want to say overwhelmed, because it's like a good thing, like just the fact that there's so, and I just love the push and pull thing, so I do like that there's just so much of, you know, this. Like, there's just, you can go from basic edit mode, which is already like pretty detailed, into like detailed, and now you're like pulling bird seeds and doing things. And excuse me, I was saying that in Blender it feels like creating poses in Blender. You know, basically like the character creation here, because there are just all these points, and you get to just move them and pose them. So it kind of felt like that, like there's just, it's, that's what it's akin to. So we have to understand this is the base game of InZoi. I would love to see InZoi in like 7 years. But this is the base game. So the base game has like 4 beards in it, which is fine. Which is fine. There's a lot happening all throughout this character creation, like from the clothing to you adding textures, just changing the colors of things, mixing and matching outfits. Like, it's, there's a lot going on that you can customize. So, you know, you can add a beard and a mustache. So it's not like, the boy's wiggling. It's like, you know, it's not the one or two, you know, you get this or you get that. You can have this mustache or this beard combo. You can make you can put the mustache and you can put a beard, so you can, you know, kind of jazz it up that way. And so yeah, because in The Sims that would have had to have been like a combination, like mustache, goatee, beard sort of thing. And no, you know what I mean? Like, I like that you can add both of them. You know, we're looking through all the hairs that are slightly afro-textured. We are not finding them, but there are some there. There are some there. You know, we were making jokes about the Killmonger. The, somebody called them the humped over dreads. Yeah. I mean, I'm trying to be nice. I guess if you don't know black people and you're like, yeah, that the hairstyle looks cool. Black people wear that, don't they? I don't personally know nobody who got their hair like that, but sure. You know, so again, anyways. So we would love more, as I guess the fun, nice way to say it is, more diversity. But y'all can put some more afro-textured hairs in there. Thank you. And now, you know, I like to throw a little lip chap on my Sims or my Zoys now. And so we gave them a little chapstick, which, you know, you can add the little makeup and stuff. These are the, like, highlights. And I don't know how to say how excited I was when I put those on. Like, look at that. Like, that just, it adds a richness to the skin if you blend the colors nicely. Like, even when they were kind of like glossy on his face, I was like, oh, we can customize these, this is gonna work. Like, it just feels like having custom content. Like, you need custom content in The Sims to do this, so this is, it's perfect for me. I'm having a great time. So we kind of think we wrapped up his face. That took me like an hour. I was really on his face for an hour. I looked at it. And, again, wouldn't trade for the world. So, we're kind of just, fleshing out the body. I will say the body controls aren't... I guess I don't know them all. Because I was watching somebody else's. And when I was creating a female, so I didn't feel like I could increase or decrease the breast size. Just, like, pull them apart or situate them different. But it seems like you can. I just needed to turn the Zoi. So there's still some learning to be done and everything. So, but my first definitive like run through of the character creation, I have genuinely no complaints. 10 out of 10. I had a great time. Like, in character creation, it's weird to say that, like, I had a good time. But I did. So now we're just making some outfits. So I'm seeing, I don't know what Chloe is, CLO, but I do know what Marvelous Designer is. And I've been intimidated by it for a long time because it's like how some simmers make CC. And so it's like a little clothing design thing. I'm not 100% sure. I don't want to sound stupid. But it seems like people have been uploaded some things from Marvelous Designer, and we are able to put those on our Zoys, which is actually pretty, like, kind of perfect. And I love this shirt. I love this shirt so much that I really did want to play with the loading textures. And I had a picture of Jean-Marie and Etienne. And so another universe, another life. This, why I was like so into this shirt is because, like, putting the picture on the shirt is because, like, I don't know if this is like a niche specific like experience, but like, have you just seen those, like, they're like Hawaiian shirts, but they have like anime characters on them, and like they're almost exclusively marketed towards fat like fat male children and teens. I say marketed like you don't just find them when you're shopping somewhere, but yeah, it just looked like that, like one of those, like, I like to call them fat boy shirts. I'm fat, shut up. So they're like, it's like one of those fat boy shirts that have like an anime character on it, and it's like slightly glossy. It just gave that, and it was funny to me. So anyways, there's a jacket, the jacket that he's wearing, highly customizable. I adore it. There's like four or five versions of this jacket in the base game, and like, you know, there's solid colors and there's prints, and you know, and then you can change the colors and there's different sizes. So you can save outfits and upload them to Canvas, and which I have been calling Canva, but that's not it. So I've been uploading things to Canvas. So uploading outfits that I create, just so hopefully when the game comes out, I'll have them, because clearly at this point, I'm just going to buy it. Yeah, great times. Great times. I truly enjoyed playing around with this, like, editor. And I'm saving the outfits. And I kind of realized, because in The Sims, you can create, like, five different outfits per, you know, category. And so with the Zoids, you can kind of just save your outfits. And so yeah, but they can really only wear one at a time, like they only have one on. So we're putting him on, I keep wanting to say the gallery, and that's not what it is, it's Canvas. So you know, I was putting some outfits of his on Canvas, and then putting him and or just saving him, and we're still going here. This is when, like, who he would be in the Zoiverse, kind of came together for me, because he's an actor, in the character I've been playing him on The Sims, but, like, he wants to direct. Oh, he does, he wants to direct, and he's living in Bliss Bay. He's kind of like a Bliss Bay fuckboy. He's like an actor, you know. And that's Jean-Marie. And Jean-Marie is like an international baddie. She's living in Doan. She might be a model, you know. Her mother works in finance, 6'5", brown eyes. I'm kidding. And her mother works in finance, and, you know, she's afforded her this fun life. And maybe she's like a model. And he's an actor. And she's popping. And he's a little jealous of her. And, yeah, that's just kind of what we were, like, you know, brainstorming up and everything. But yeah, I don't know why, I just felt like he needed outfits. And then also this jacket being customizable, I don't know why at this point, still took me by surprise, but I enjoyed it. Okay, love that jacket. But we are making him just a little bit of like another outfit, just because I had fun in the outfit. Like, I just had fun here. Like, there was, you know, just getting into the options and, you know, customizing everything. Like, look at that. Like, it's a leather jacket. Red and black. Okay, fresh as I'm is. And then we put a jersey on him, and we can customize that too. So stay tuned, because coming up, I do have some you'll just see us kind of having fun in the studio version of this character creation. We had some music going. And yeah, so thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned to the channel. If you're new here, I guess I will be posting in InZoi stuff when it comes out. And stay tuned for some Sim stuff. Bye. Altsy, welcome in. What is Sims about? They're gonna have to step that shit up. Okay, go ahead. Shake that ass, ho. Oh, wow. Okay. I don't think I did this dance yet.
Shake that ass, ho. Shake that ass, ho.
Why he on beat a little bit? Y'all ain't had to go off like that. I'ma play both. I feel like I will. They patented the pull and grab, and this company's using it. Did they patent that? Me, myself, and I, and the Rose, Ebony, Leslie, X videos, big titty blonde hat, and a Nicole, spicy Spanish, hottie, nympho. Niggas call it pussy rap, really, I'm just being bad. You can call me Baby D, cause I love to talk snacks on the ones and the twos. I'm spinning my shit. It's DJ. These animations are kind of like top tier, and there's a lot of them. Y'all just sitting there looking at him, cause he's, ooh. Pixelate, yeah, no. You, I think you spelled it right. They won't, cause people still play Sims 2 and 3. We'll play both and none of the other. That's true. Hi, Shalom. Welcome in. Some folks won't be into this more Second Life vibe of realism, and some will. That's true. I think there'll be some Sims players who just kind of won't super be into it. You know they're going to say it looks like alpha, and that apparently that means ghetto. So we love a dog whistle, don't we? Boy, you better absolutely. Wait, because why he riding that beat like that though? Go ahead, Etienne. Let's go. Like, He ate that shit up. I'm sorry, that little... Listen, that's me 3 vodka shots in the bar, all right? Let's go, Antia. Fuck it up. Jelly. But she looks like an ass at the deli. Go ahead, Jean. Go ahead, girl. Jean-Marie. Dancing on these hoes. Get it. Sister. Ow. Go. Sister, go. A sister. Ow. Ooh. She is eating that shit up. I feel like they on beat too. Somebody made these poses that's got the 1-2 rhythm. It's the fact that it's Jean that has me cracked up. I love it. Right now. It's gonna do what, Jean Marie?
It's only gonna get you high.
Go ahead, girl. Go ahead, bitch. Absolutely. mean, she's absolutely eating this shit alive. I kind of can't wait to get the game. Like, I can't really wait to get the game. She's a top twin. Go ahead, Sean. I mean, the grocery store with A. Touch me, squeeze me, roll out. On the frozen aisle, absolutely let them have it. You better go ahead, Jean. She said, that just eats me up right there. Go ahead, sister.
Take a bite. It's a sour candy. Take a bite. So sour candy.